The request library has a built-in JSON decoder to work with JSON content when it is sent in response from the server. The JSON decoder allows us to parse the JSON response into Python objects. JSON stands for JavaScript Object Notation, and it is an easy and light format to transport data between a server and a client. Data in JSON format is stored in name and value pairs, separated by commas. Objects are denoted by the use of curly braces, and arrays are defined by square brackets. We will start by creating a new script with the request library imported. Next, we will create a new response object R and set this equal to request.get. To use the JSON decoder in the request library, we need response content that is formatted as JSON. One server that returns JSON content is the list of public events from the GitHub API. In our get function, we will add the URL api.github.com/events. When the request is made, the response object R will contain content in JSON format. To parse this response data into Python objects, we will call the JSON function on the response object R. Then we will assign this to an object called events. Now that this events object has the data from the response formatted as a Python object, what can we do with it? Say we wanted to access the first event in the array. We can add square brackets with the index of 0 to the events object. Now only the first event is printed to the console. We can retrieve the ID from this first event by adding another set of square brackets to the event object with the string ID. This will return the ID of the first event in the array. This is just one example of retrieving specific data from an object created from parsed JSON content. We can also send JSON content in a request using the request library. To send JSON content to the server, the request method contains a keyword, JSON, that we can add to our request. We will define a new dictionary called data and add the key first name with the value John. Next, we will change our get request to a post request and change the URL to httpbin.org/post. This endpoint will return a response object showing the JSON content we sent to the server. To JSON encode and add our dictionary to the request, we will assign the dictionary data to the JSON keyword. One reason we want this JSON keyword is to JSON encode a form and then post the JSON object to the server. When we call the text function on the response object R, we can see our JSON content that was sent to the server within the JSON section of the response object. For more Python tutorials, like, share, and subscribe to the PyPros channel.